Sounds like they're out back. We can use the crates as cover to get closer. I'll cover you.
You first, killer.
I knew we should have surrendered. They're gonna shoot us. Then why is your son here with a gun? He's supposed to be on our side.
Put the gun down.
Where Marsden is.
Here's Marsden, you son of a bitch.
Thanks, Mom.
Michael, what are you doing?
Putting blood on my shirt.
Well, that can't be very sanitary.
Mom, I need to look like I've been fatally wounded. I'd rather not do it with a real bullet.
Ward! Grant! What's going on?
I need to go back out there. When I'm clear, I need you to shoot at the crate.
Then hide in the back with the other hostages and have everyone take cover.
You ready?
Where's Ward?
He didn't make it. Marsden was waiting for us. Man, he caught me in the liver.
Move your hand. I can stop the bleeding.
Don't bother. It's over. I saw a guy in the joint take a shiv in the same spot.
That son of a bitch. I'm putting Marsden in the ground right now.
No. I got an idea. Marsden said he wants us to surrender.
Oh, we are not surrendering.
You give me the grenade. I'll call Marsden out. I'll tell him we're giving ourselves up. When I get close to him and the hostages, I pull the pin. I'll kill them all.
You would do that?
When you get Grom back, you take my cut, and you send it to my mom. She's in the old folks' home in Homestead.
You have my word.
Marsden! We want to talk. Don't shoot. We want to make a deal. Go. Go now.
In trench warfare, a common practice is to dig a hole called a grenade sump. It works on a simple principle. When a grenade falls into your trench, you kick it into a deeper hole, which directs the force of the grenade upward. The same idea can work above ground with large pieces of furniture.
That lowlife better not be pulling something.
That lowlife just saved your ass. Show some respect.